There is Linux in your pocket right now. Let's talk about how you can access it. This is my Samsung S21 Ultra. This is a 2021 flagship from Samsung, and it's a fast phone. This is a very fast phone. However, and I can't stress this enough, if you have a phone that was made in the last few years, it's probably a lot faster than you think. Especially, well, okay, so even older phones are getting really good. In fact, you can probably go out and buy a few years old flagship for just a couple hundred dollars, and it's going to be really good. You don't have to get the newest, the greatest. You don't have to be like my ridiculous self and get a flagship. You don't have to. It's going to be fast. They're all fast. And if you're running Android, you have something in there that's kind of magical when you think about it. Because there's a little bit of Linux in here. Right here. So Android is powered by a fork of the Linux kernel. And when I say a fork, I gotta keep in mind, like, they take the kernel, as we understand it, kernel.org, the same kernel that was put on a lot of our Linux systems. And what they do is, first, Google grabs it and modifies it, makes the Android kernel. There's a lot of good Linux-y stuff inside there. And then they send it to the hardware manufacturers. So Samsung gets it after Google's messed with it. They grab the Android kernel, and then they make the Samsung Android Linux kernel. And that's what shows up on your devices. Well, if you have Samsung, you know, insert name of brand of the kernel of your manufacturer. Unless you're running something like Lineage OS, then you have the Lineage kernel, which is cool. But again, a lot of cool Linux-y things are still in here. The thing is, they're kind of hidden under the surface. And that's where a platform like Termux comes in very handy, because Termux kind of helps bridge that missing user space that Android is, you know, just happen to not have available to you. So what you need to do is you need to get a copy of Termux. You can launch that application, and then you have the user space, your command line tools, and they all talk to the Linux kernel baked inside your magical phone. This is cool. Side note, I would not get Termux from the Google Play Store. It's actually outdated. That's from a 2020 build. And this thing is regularly updated. So the best places and the recommended places from the developer is either through FDroid or directly off the Termux GitHub releases page. I will link both of those below. And that's the best place to get it. So you're thinking, okay, I have Linux-y goodness. What can I do with it? Well, there's a lot you can do with it. There is a lot. The maintainers of the Termux distribution, I guess you could say, they have up-to-date packages. There is SSH servers, HTTP servers, PHP, Python, Java, anything you can really think of to do with a normal Linux stack. A lot of that can be done with a noticeable missing element, Docker, which is a whole nother video and one of my biggest rants. We need Docker for Android. And Google needs to help with that. They're not going to, but they need to. You can still do quite a bit of development. I've installed Hugo and Jekyll on my phone and was able to build and deploy directly from the command line. And there are a lot of really cool tools. Spreadsheet calculator improved, it's there. Pandoc, it's there. SSH and Mosh, it's there. C-Matrix. You can do ridiculously fun things on there too. Do yourself a favor. If you want a little bit of Linux in your pocket, Termux is going to give you about 99% of what you need. Are you one of the few brilliant minds who have jumped all over the power of Termux? Is this something you can find yourself using every day like I do? Every day. I use it every day. It's amazing. Let me know in the comments below. Yes.